democracy, what it looks like, how is it supposed to function ideally, what is it supposed to look like from Egypt. There's a couple of like, false assumptions, I think, that we made on this side of the house, and that is that democracies, or Egyptian democracy has to look like democracy in the United States, for one, because they're like, oh, we want pluralism to look just like the United States, which I think if the Muslim Brotherhood was elected by the people of Egypt, if that's not what the Black Bloc is, we agree with their movement in principle, and we think that they are going to let in and have to make Egypt better. That's what we've heard. And my second is that our perception of the Black Bloc, both in the West, in Egypt itself, with the Egyptian people, does that matter? Does that matter in the context of our debate today? And third, what is the Indian? This is three questions. So we'll talk about Black Bloc as an effective agent of change. We've heard that we have we're fighting for the voice of the people, but at the same time, we're like, yeah, we acknowledge that they use violence, we're okay with that half the time, and we don't really agree with everything that they stand for. We don't really want them to be like involved in government after they're done, like after they've kind of accomplished their goal within the process, and we don't really think that they're going to be a valid, maybe a long-term solution. The problem with that idea is, and why they're ineffective agents of change, is that you don't get to pick and choose what you like about a movement or what you don't like about a movement. You're stuck with what that movement represents in its entirety. And what we're finding, what we see is Black Bloc in that context. I just don't think that that's the way to go. Of course, it's the way to love.
Okay, so here's the thing. Real governments fight so they can get re-elected through actually representing aggregate interests. You only do this when you have long-term goals. These people enforce Morsi to recognize that I actually have to be a government.
Okay, so here's the problem. So secularist movements who are in the government that are legitimate, that aren't acting out in violence, but who do you find out, who do you hear about, who's making news, who's getting a reaction around the world? It's Black Bloc, and they're a violent act. So it's not so much their ideology that we're hearing, it is in fact just the violence that's associated with the movement. We don't think that is the long-term currency of political change that Egypt needs to have. We think that you're arguing for it, but the reality behind it is that you're perpetuating a currency of violence and a culture of violence within that culture, and that only true political change can occur through violence. And that's what you're arguing for from this side of the house. We disagree with it. We don't think that's what Black Bloc is an effective agent of change. We just don't buy it. One is their co-op. They're second actresses within Egypt. Not just a select few. They're advocating violence. Perceptions matter, and this is really vitally important. Calvin brought this out to us. We think that the perception of the Black Bloc, both externally and particularly within the current government as it stands right now, is absolutely vital and absolutely important. The reason why is because what the Black Bloc does, what the violence that ensues across the board, we've seen it in throughout this condition. We have a minority rhetoric in which they clamp down and label them as terrorists, to then tighten their restrictions across the board. We've even seen it within our own government times. It was brought up on the House where, you know, September 11th, we talked about documents of change, like democracy. We give up our personal freedoms through, we got an act about September 11th. We're like, okay, we're okay with the Patriot Act because it's fun now. That's okay. No, these are perceptions of change. We don't believe it. One of the biggest issues we got by government is the third point of the end game. But the end game, we talked about it. The broad arms out has no been. If the Inde is some pseudo anarchy movement, right? And you're like, yeah, we agree with the Black Bloc. They should represent the face of Egyptian secularism. Okay, we're okay. Okay, they can be violent. They can argue for change, but they never really make the process of change. We think that that's where they're ineffective agents of change, and that the perception of that change absolutely does matter. As Calvin brought up, he gave us some good points about being linked to other organizations that have. The reason why they are not an effective agent of change is because of the fact they don't have the political discourse or even the will for political discourse, if they're true anarchists in that sense, to be changed. Here's an example. What did they end up becoming? A political movement and a political body that then had representation in Ireland itself. Is it perfect? No. But they had an in-game in that construct. That's the only way. Calvin brought up the idea that in Israel and Palestine. Perfect example, I think, that can be applied here. We see a government is used by those in power to suppress because the perception is that Hamas is followed as terrorists. That's the perception, because it's the rhetoric that's given by the government in this case. You're going to see that same line, and all that leads to, all that then becomes, is just an entrenchment of these two. not actual discourse. The discourse becomes the currency of violence and not the currency of change, which is discussion and the ideas that lead